Hello guys, Ivano here. In this video, we're going to learn how to use the Substance plugin for Blender. So let's get started. After installing the plugin, we will be able to find it in the Shader Editor right panel, inside a tab called Shallow Tool. To load a substance, we go to the top of the UI, and in the File Path parameter, we select a substance file. This will automatically read the substance and fill up the rest of the UI with its available parameters. Below the file path is the material parameter. This will be the name of the material once it is created. It gets filled automatically when you load a substance file, but you can change this name anytime you want. For example, if we click Create Material, a material called Alien Ship Techno Panel is added to Blender. If we rename it to Alien Ship, and click Create Material again, now a material called Alien Ship is added to Blender. Besides the material parameter, there are two buttons. The first one is the Create Instance. When you click it, it will duplicate the current substance material. That way, you will be able to save multiple iterations of the same substance material inside a Blender file. The second button is the Reset button. This one will reset all the parameters of the substance file to their default values. For example, if we change the glow color to blue, and then click Reset, it becomes orange again. After the material parameter, we'll find the Assign to Selected checkbox. If enabled, the substance material will be assigned to all the selected mesh objects, as you can see here. If disabled, the material will be created, but you'll need to assign it later. The default value of this checkbox can be configured on the add-on's preferences, as we saw in the last video. Then we have the Output Configuration subpanel. This panel contains the main rules that will be used when creating a substance material inside Blender. We start with the Use Relative path. As we explained in the previous video, if enabled, the vague textures of the substance will be stored in a path that is relative to the currently active blend file, as we can see here. If disabled, they will be stored in a default output path. This is an absolute path of your computer, as we can see here. Beside the path, we have an Open Folder button. This will open the folder you are using to store the vague textures. Then we have the resolution that establishes the vague resolution as a power of 2, and the tiling that defines how many times the material will be repeated. Both the resolution and the tiling can be locked to use the same value for X and Y, or unlocked and use different values. Then we have the format, which defines the file format to be used on the vague textures, PNG, TIFF, JPEG, etc. And as we explained in the previous video, the default values of these parameters can be configured in the add-on preferences. Next, we have the render parameter. This one defines what kind of shader network will be created. By default, there are two presets, Cycle CV and Octane. You can create more presets, for example, if you need to use a custom workflow, but that will be shown in a future video. Then we have the Substance Engine that will be used. Here you can select between using CPU or GPU to make the textures, and usually GPU is faster. Finally, we have the extra parameters, High Scale and Emissive Intensity, which define the values that will be used for the High Scale and the Emissive Intensity when creating the shader network. It's worth noting that all the parameters that we have seen so far will apply to all the substance files. The next ones will vary depending on each file. After the Output Configuration panel, we'll be able to find the Outputs panel. The outputs that appear here depends completely on the outputs available in the substance file, and will be enabled automatically, depending on the render preset you selected. By default, the presets are using the Metal Roughness workflow, and the presets will be smart enough to recognize if there is an opacity, emissive, height, or any other additional map output in the substance that needs to be enabled. If you disable an output, that output won't be considered on the creation of the material. For example, if we have a substance with an emissive output, we disable the emissive and click Create Material, then the created material will have a new zip line. If we enable it again and click Create, the missive lights are back. The final thing you can do in this section is to set the bit depth you want to use in each output. By default, everything is 8, with the exception of the normal and height outputs that are set to 16, following common standards. And finally, we have the parameters and technical parameters panels. These panels will contain all the parameters available in the Substance file, and will change from Substance to Substance. If you have Live Update enabled, each time you change a parameter from these sections, the material will be updated. If you have it disabled, you will need to click either Create Material or Refresh Textures. The difference between Create Material and Refresh Textures is that Create Material will delete the existing Blender material and create a new one from scratch, and Refresh will only bake the textures again and reload them in Blender. This is an important difference to consider, especially if you modify the shader network after you create the Substance material the first time. Well, that's all for now. In the next video, we'll learn how to use the plugin with Octane for Blender.
Good luck!